We often talk about classical and operant conditioning separately. However, they can be used together to change behavior. A perfect example of this is the story of Callie the sea lion. Let's go talk to Dr. Zelligs about this. She can tell us more.
Callie's backstory is both heartbreaking and inspirational. So she's the youngest of my group, and she is, I believe, 8 years old at this point. She was one of the youngest surviving premature baby sea lions that has ever made it. She was born more than 1 month premature, and her mother died of domoic acid poisoning, which is a type of toxic algae. It's a neurotoxin. Callie was exposed to that toxin in utero and has a huge range of neurologic and gastrointestinal problems as a result of this exposure. So it's been touch and go her whole life. And one of her big problems is because of this really sort of form of brain damage, she doesn't like food. So her natural instinct is to starve herself. And we have had to use classical conditioning actually to keep her alive, because what she does like is behavior and people because of how she was raised. So we use behavior and people to reward her for eating, which is the opposite of what you normally think, but it's a great testimony to what classical and operant conditioning can do. And today, she's alive and healthy.
So learning saved her life.
Learning saved her life, and she has learned to like fish.